Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video. Now what I'm going to do this time around is review a piece of rolling stock, and I have added a question into this video, which will be, should I review rolling stock as well as model trains, or just keep to the locomotive side of things? Because to be honest, I'm not sure how popular reviews of rolling stock such as this Mark III DVT in the Arriva Trains Wales livery, or even any rolling stock for that matter, will be, as this is the model I'm going to be reviewing as an experiment in my new videos, as I've had this model for quite a long time, and this one did come with me in my luggage from England, as you may have seen it in many model train running sessions. So this actually got me thinking if to do rolling stock or just keep with the locomotives and train parks only. So please do let me know by clicking on the eye icon in the top right corner of the video, as that will be an interactive question for those of you that watch this video. But anyways, this is the Arriva Trains Wales, and it's also in Welsh, although I'm not going to attempt to try and read that, as I don't want to offend anybody, as that is not my intentions. Moving on, here is the details on the back. The reference number is R4640, Arriva Trains Wales Mark III DVT. And this one is numbered as 82307. And I believe that Arriva Trains Wales, I believe the operations has changed hands since I've owned this, but I can't remember who the new owner is. But these would be used with Class 67s, if I remember correctly, and the rake of four Mark IIIs. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pause the video momentarily whilst I unbox this piece of rolling stock. And I will place it onto the turntable for some close-ups, and then I will do a wee model train running session just to show off the cab lights and the head and tail lights. More on that later. Now that I've removed all of the packaging, here is the model in full view on my turntable that is placed on this section of track, just to make it handling it easier, and so it doesn't roll off the turntable onto the floor. I have painted the buffers myself using the Tamiya flat black, which is a very good colour for the buffers that I would paint my model trains with. And I have fitted one of the ESU accessory LokPilot decoders into this Mark III DVT, just to allow me to control the head and tail lights whilst the train is on DCC mode. But passive mode is enabled on this decoder by default, so that'd be the reason why the lights will work as normal. And here are the instructions which do come with the model. So I'm just going to zoom out just so I can show you the paperwork easier. And this just shows you how to fit the decoder if you wish to, and how to remove the body as well. And here is the printed circuit board, of which has the 8-pin DCC interface. And you can also fit the optional brake pipes, etc. Although, to be truthful, this model did come already fitted with the brake pipes and the MU cables, so I don't need to do anything with this model really, as it is ready to use straight out of the box, especially on DCC, as this one has the ESU LokPilot. So what I'm going to do, just going to place these instructions to one side safely. I'm going to zoom back in a wee bit closer to the model train, which is the Mark III DVT. This one is numbered as 82307, and it is a fantastic model from Hornby. As with the majority of their premium models anyways, just going to zoom out quite far, just so that I can keep all of the, or try to keep most of the model in full view of the camera, although I've slightly clipped the rear there. And all of the handrails are independently fitted as well, and you do have a PCV rubber corridor vestibule on the back, and I have painted the metal buffers into black as well, just to make the model look more realistic when used on my oval of track. And to be truthful, I do like to detail my model trains, as they look more realistic with things like painted buffers and drivers in the locomotive part where there is none fitted, as well as adding the brake pipes and the other details as well. Just coming back to the front of the model, as you can see there, the model does have etched window wipers as well, and the buffers are sprung, although these ones are a wee bit stiff, as this one has been stored for quite a long time in this box, with the exception of my model train running sessions that I've done in the recent years. And now we will move on to the close-ups, and I will let the detail of this model Mark III DVT from Hornby do the torquing for itself. Absolutely beautiful detail. Not sure if this camera is picking it up, but you can see the footsteps and the metal wheels and the detailing on the trucks, or bogies, whichever you prefer to call them. I generally call them trucks or wheel sets, as it does sound a bit more polite, to be honest. And you do have flush glazing and etched grills too, which I would assume would be for the air conditioning, etc. And just look at that beautiful detail. And coming back to the start along the roof, there is the radio pod and an exhaust of some kind, although it's not a diesel engine, as these Mark III DVTs are not powered by their own right. And to be honest, to describe the role of the DVT, or the driving van trailer, it's like a giant remote control for the locomotive at the other end. As the driver, or engineer, whichever part of the world you are, would call the person who drives the train. Basically, the driver would move controls here, and this would send commands through the MU cables to the locomotive to accelerate, brake, power up and power down, move forward and backwards, etc. It's a bit like the remote control on your TV, but on a much, much larger scale. And that's my best way of describing the actions of the DVT anyways. So, next thing to do is to put the DVT onto the track. I will be using a Lima Class 62 propeller train just for to see how it handles whilst in the DVT is at the front of the train on this occasion. Fingers crossed there'll be no derailments, but the reason I'm doing this mainly is to show off the cab lights and the headlights. So I will return once I've placed this train onto the track. Okay then, now that I have the Mk3 DVT on the train set up and ready to go, what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to reach over and power up the background train, of which will be 6006 on the tankers. And without further ado, let's power up the pilot locomotive that will be propelling this train in the reverse direction. Not quite sure how this will turn out, as this is the first time that I've used the Mk3 DVT at the front of any train, as I tend to use it in tail mode, as it usually runs at the back of the train. But this is typical how the Mk3 DVT would remotely control the locomotive at the other end of the train, and it would propel it, as shown here. And the reason I've used my Lima Class 60 is because, unlike the Hornby models, which have the narrow NEM tension lock couplers, which are prone to derailing on curves, I've used the Lima Class 60 due to having wider loop couplers, as this should improve stability. And I've not run it too fast either. But I guess this is the first time that I've shown the Mk3 DVT in this position, showing off the cab lights and the headlights. As far as I'm aware, there is no day and night mode. I believe this is the only mode there is on the Mk3 DVT, unless it is selectable via the DCC decoder, of which I have no idea, as I've not used the Mk3 DVT on DCC mode as of yet. But I'm sure you would agree that the lighting is very nice on the Mk3 DVT. I'm not sure if to add a driver into the cab yet or not, as I usually run the DVT at the back of the train. But anyways, just as a reminder for those of you that have not yet answered the question, that is the interactive question on my video, should I review more rolling stock, or should I stick to locomotives and train packs only in terms of my model train reviews? Please do let me know by answering the question. This is a simple question of yes or no, as I would appreciate on your feedback on this idea, please. Anyways, I'm going to round this review of the Hornby Mk3 DVT in the Arriva Trains Wales off with a perfect 10 out of 10, as it is a fantastic model, and I do like the cab lights and the headlights, although you may have seen the tail lights on this Mk3 DVT from my model train running sessions. But anyways, thank you for watching. All the best and cheerio. I will see you in the next video.